Hey, what's up YouTube? Back with your boy Luke. Okay guys, check this out. The title of today's video, Why Man Pay for Sex. And guys, this video should be watched by girls and guys. Normally I just do videos for guys. I have about 98% of my subscribers are male subscribers, according to my YouTube analytics. But females, you gotta listen to this one too. Okay guys, go ahead and smash that like and subscribe button if you're new here. I'm in Mexico in my official Adelita Bar shirt. I'm gonna get right down to it. Why man pay for sex? See guys, here's the thing. Men actually always pay for sex, okay? Indirectly or directly, you pay for sex. I don't care if you go straight to Figueroa Street in Los Angeles and you pick up a prostitute and you pay her, or you take a girl out, you take her to dinner, you buy her drinks, you take her to Vegas, you take her to a show, you take her to a movie, you take her to the casino, you take her to Six Flags. It doesn't matter, guys. You're gonna be spending money on that girl, okay? Guys, sex is just like a car. Even if I give you the car free, there's other costs that are associated with that car, such as maintenance, insurance, gas, okay? It costs money. Get it through your head. It costs money. Now, I'm sure there's one female out there watching this saying, I pay for half, whatever. I'm sure you do. I'm sure you pay for half of everything, sweetheart. And guys, here's the thing. As you get older, from your teens and your 20s and your 30s, and you actually shack up with these girls, now you're even paying a lot of times their rent, their health insurance, their car note. The expenses just keep growing and growing and growing, okay? So actually, I'm gonna be quite honest with you. I've run the numbers, I've looked at it several times. Unless the girl that you're with, unless you're married and she's making six figures, big time money, it's way cheaper just to pay for sex than it is to actually get it the traditional way. Guys, not only is it cheaper, but here's the real reason why a lot of guys are doing it. It's easier. It's less time consuming. I mean, before I made this video, I was riding down the road with a girlfriend of mine and she said, you know, all you have to do is go to a nightclub, talk to some women, buy them some drinks, take them out. That's what they're there for. And then you can have sex with them later. And I said, yeah, but see, a lot of guys don't want to do that. Why do I want to go out, chance wasting 5, 6, 7 hours of my time, spending money, okay, on something that's a maybe? Why would you do that? That's why men are choosing just to go down, pick up a prostitute, pick up a girl in Mexico, you know, wherever it's legal, Las Vegas, Mexico, things like that, and just pay for the sex. Just go directly to the source. It's so much easier, okay? 100%. So there you go, girls. It's 100% easier, it's less time consuming, and it's actually cheaper. All right, guys, let me roll into something else too. I wanna tell you guys a story that one time I was down in Mexico with a girlfriend of mine. I had taken her out to a nice Italian restaurant, and I've told this story on YouTube before, but I'm gonna go ahead and repeat it. I took her out to a nice Italian restaurant. We had been drinking. We watched a fight that night. I think Canelo was fighting somebody. Went to a nice dinner. Went to a couple nice bars. Everything was going good, right? And this girl was a nice girl. She really was. So, as we're driving back home, she says, what are you always doing videos about those whorehouses for? What are you always doing videos about those prostitutes for? They're gross. You know how she gets, right? Drunk, belligerent, starting to be, you know, quite frankly, a bitch. And, you know, it just so happened to be that we were right by Zona Norte. We were right by the Adelita Bar. And I said, you know what? I said, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take you into the Adelita Bar and let you experience this for yourself. She's like, that's fine. I bet they're all ugly. You know how women get, right? Okay, guys. So we pull down to Zona Norte. We park at the Chicago Club. We walk over to the Adelita Bar, and when we walk in here, there's like 200 hot girls everywhere. It's like a Friday or a Saturday night, right? You got girls dancing, you got girls talking to guys, girls that are walking around in bikinis, short shorts, girls that are, you know, basically propositioning these guys. Because if you don't know, guys, down in Tijuana, it has a legal red light district, okay? It's 100% legal. So, here we go. I look at her, and she could not believe it. She just looked like she had been just hit by Mike Tyson. She just couldn't move, right? She's sitting there like this. And I was like, hey, would you relax? Sure enough, girl comes over, girl sets down, and she's like, do you want to go upstairs and have some fun? I said, well, you're going to have to convince my girlfriend. And this girl, she was so cute. She looked over at my girlfriend and she said, hey, do you want to go upstairs? Two's more fun than three. Or three's more fun than two is what she said. My girlfriend was absolutely horrified. And then I asked the girl, I said, well, I'm just curious. What would it cost to go upstairs? And she said, well, if you got a $100 bill on you, that'd take care of it. She said, about 80 for me and then 20 for some other incidentals like the room and stuff like that. I go, cool, sounds great. I go, you know what? We're going to pass, but thank you for your time. You're beautiful. All right. She gets up. She leaves. We get up. We leave. We get back in the car. Driving back to the house. The bitch attitude went straight to a very sad, a very dejected attitude. I brought her ass right back down to reality, just like that. Finally, she admits to me. She goes, wow, those girls were very beautiful. They all had perfect bodies. I go, well, yeah, that's their business. And most of them have, you know, they've had work done to their bodies to be that perfect. Very few of them are naturally that beautiful. And she goes, but I can totally understand why a guy would just rather pay the money and go have fun like that, as opposed to be in a relationship, as opposed to being responsible, as opposed to having to invest time. And she goes, and what I couldn't believe is the price that girl quoted you was actually less expensive than it would really take a girl to go out on a date. And I said, that's 100% what I'm trying to say. So there you go again, guys. I'm not just talking about, and girls, the reason why men pay for sex is because it's faster and it's easier and it's cheaper. But you don't have to deal with all the other responsibilities that come within a relationship. Be it Christmas at her dad's house, Easter at her mom's house, so-and-so's birthday, the sister's wedding. I mean, it's nonstop, okay? So it is a whole lot easier just to pay for it, in my opinion. You guys hit that comment section. Let me know what you think too. Let me know if you think I'm right or if I'm wrong or if I'm crazy. To you younger guys out there, remember this. Don't worry so much about women right now, guys. Control the controllables. Work on yourself. Save money. Don't have kids. Stay single. Get your own place. Get your own car. Get ready to go. All right, guys. Like I said, if you're new here, go ahead and smash that like and subscribe button. Thank you so much for watching my videos. One more thing I am going to mention is what a lot of girls will automatically revert back to is the STD factor. All those girls are nasty. They probably have STDs. You're sick. That's what girls are going to say. Yet, they're not sick when they go to the nightclub and they're dancing and they meet some guy that no one ever finds out about, okay? And they go back to that guy's house and, you know, she lets him blow her back out. And the next day she goes down to the pharmacy and she buys the day after pill. I'm going to be real honest with you. I don't have a lot of experience in a lot of parts of the world, but I do in the red light district of Tijuana, Mexico. All the girls in the red light district of Tijuana, Mexico, because that is a legal government sanctioned organization. They actually have a labor union, believe it or not. But anyway, they're all tested for STDs all the time. Every type of sex just about is, you know, used protection, using condoms, things of that nature. And I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to put money on it. I guarantee you the girls at the Adelita Bar, the girls at the Hong Kong Club, the girls at the Chicago Club, the girls in Zona Norte, they are a lot less likely to get an STD than these girls at Coyote Ugly or Country 2000 or Mason's, wherever you go in Las Vegas, right? These regular nightclub girls. Because these girls are just out, you know, partying, drinking, acting irresponsible, and basically throwing ass for free. At least these professional girls are safe about it. They are educated about the situation. So don't give me that, oh, you're going to get an STD, and that's sick, and that's disgusting. Come on, sweetheart. You've done worse. You know you have. Guys, go ahead and smash that like and subscribe button. Appreciate everything you guys do. Be cool. Be safe. We'll see you down the road.